Greetings, friends, and welcome to Bear's Den in northern Loudoun County, and welcome to the third week of Deeply Rooted. And this week, friends, is all about sacred partnerships. You know, there's something really amazing about human nature, and that is our ability to cooperate, partner, and share with the people around us. You know, we build bonds with friends and neighbors. We care for and help family and loved ones. We join sports teams or groups that share an interest in a particular activity, and we often find ourselves making decisions to help people who we don't know because they're struggling with challenging circumstances, even when there's nothing necessarily in it for us. We just do it because we want to care and serve the people around us. We also make agreements with companies that provide services to us. We sign contracts for the jobs that we hold and the homes that we live in. You know, cooperating and collaborating are weaved into the fabric of our collective humanity. It is a part of who we are. And over the course of thousands of years, we've also made sacred and holy agreements, like marriages. Marriages between two people are meant to be holy and sacred agreements. When a child is born and the family wants to have that child baptized, the church community makes a commitment to walk with that child and her parents through thick and thin so that she can grow up in the faith. And when we join a faith community, we make a commitment to serve, to share, to give, and to be present so that people might know about the love of God. And the word that best represents the mutual and sacred partnerships and relationships that we form is covenant. And I found this really great definition from the writer Curtis Almquist that I think would be really good for you all to hear. It says, in a covenant, two or more individuals, each respecting the dignity and integrity of the other, come together in a bond of love and trust to share their interests, sometimes even share their lives by pledging faithfulness to one another to do together what neither can do alone. A covenant is about a relationship. A relationship that invites and presumes a transformative change in both persons. In Scripture, there are a number of instances where God makes a covenant with the people. And we, here today, are heirs of these covenants in and through Jesus Christ, who sought to adopt all people into the family of God. And that's a wonderful and really interesting thing to consider, that we here in modern America are in the midst of a story that begins with creation and continues to unfold here and now. We are a part of God's story. God's story of love being shared again and again with humanity. Each and every one of us in the covenantal relationship has a role to play. And as we continue to build our faith, we have an opportunity. We have an opportunity to not only identify, but also understand and ultimately strengthen the covenants that we have in our lives, both the ones that are spoken and unspoken, like our ones with God, with our loved ones, with our neighbors, and even our deeply rooted life groups. And I wonder if you noticed in our scripture reading today where Moses tells the people to get ready for this covenant, this really remarkable event by getting cleaned up and washing their clothes. And that had me thinking. It had me thinking about our relationships and the special nature of our relationships and what we bring to the table. And in sacred relationships, in sacred partnerships, we have to bring our best, most authentic and real selves to the table. And when we wash away the junk of our lives, when we scrub out the preconceived notions of ourselves and others, we are free to explore relationships in new and meaningful ways. When we bring our best to our relationships, it changes our lives and the lives of the people around us. And it allows us to move into these sacred relationships with the intention of mutuality, vulnerability, and respect. And that, my friend, is worth it. Peace be with you. Take care, and we'll see you next week.